We have already seen that Birsa Munda was unhappy with the land policies of the British because it was destroying their traditional land system. Moreover, he was also unhappy with the Hindu landlords and the money lenders because they were taking their land. And the Christian missionaries were destroying their traditional practices. So he was unhappy with all these people, and so he started the movement, and slowly, slowly the movement started spreading. When the movement spread, the British were forced to act. So they arrested Birsa in the year 1895, and he was charged or convicted for rioting. Rioting means creating problem and destroying the property of the zamindars and others. So he was charged for rioting, and then he was jailed for 2 years. So after 2 years, when Birsa was released from the jail in 1897, then he started spreading his movement by touring all the villages, the nearby villages, and he wanted to gather support of the people to spread the movement. And for that, he used some traditional symbols and languages. Now, he started urging the people to destroy the Ravanas. He called the Dikus and the Europeans as Ravanas. Dikus we have already studied. The moneylenders and the traders were called as Dikus. So, he urged the followers that we should destroy the Ravanas. And we should have a kingdom, and that kingdom should be under the control of the Munda Raj. That means under his leadership, he wanted a new kingdom. So that is why he started targeting the symbols of the Dikus, symbols of the moneylenders, traders, and the Europeans. And he, along with his followers, also attacked the police stations and churches, and then the property of the moneylenders and the zamindars were also raided, is taken away by these people. And his symbol was white flag. So he raised white flag as symbol of Birsa Raj. So his movement continued up to 1900, but in 1900 Birsa died because of cholera. And after his death, there was no capable leader to carry on the Munda movement. So slowly, slowly the Munda movement faded away. Now this Birsa Munda's movement, or this Munda movement, was significant in two ways. Of course, there was no other leader to continue, but still this movement forced the British to introduce such laws that the land of the tribals cannot be easily taken away by the British. So, making of such law was one of the significant result of Birsa movement. Secondly, it showed to the British that the tribals can also express their anger and they can also protest against the injustice. So, in two ways, Birsa movement was significant. So this is all about this chapter, Tribals, Dikus, and the Mission of a Golden Age.